I'm the Director of Conservation and Education at Ontario Nature. And Ontario Nature is a charitable organization. We're a conservation, provincial conservation organization that has been working to protect wild species and wild spaces in Ontario since 1931. We're a federation of over 150 member groups across Ontario, including Nature London. And we represent over 30,000 members and supporters across the province.
So it's quite a large organization then.
It is. We have a relatively small staff. We have a staff of about 20. We have our head office in Toronto, and then we have another office in Thunder Bay.
Now, a few weeks ago, one of the handful of remaining northern white rhinos passed away, leaving his species on the brink of extinction. Personally, I did not know that species were that low. Do you think that people are not talking about the endangered species issue enough, or are they just being ignorant?
Well, I don't think people know enough about these things, and I don't think people are talking about them enough either. You're right, rhinos are in big trouble, and they're symptomatic of what's happening around the world. And I don't know, Greg, if you were aware of a report that was put out about a month ago by the World Wildlife Fund, but anyway, according to that report, in just the last 40 years, we have lost half of the planet's wildlife.
Wow.
Half of the mammals, birds, fish, reptiles, and amphibians on the planet have disappeared in less than my lifetime, personally.
That's amazing, just how many we've lost.
It's absolutely frightening.
I know I read earlier that we lose 10,000 different species a year, roughly.
Yes. Well, I know that species loss is a huge problem everywhere, and in Ontario.
Now, everyone can mention the well-known endangered species, for example, the white tiger or the panda, but it's hard to think of any that are endangered right here in Ontario, or even London area. What are some of the animals endangered close to home?
Well, that is a very good point, because often it's those charismatic things like tigers and rhinos that get the attention, but there are lots of endangered species here in Ontario. We have over 200 species that are known to be at risk in Ontario, and one of those is the woodland caribou. So if you take out your quarter, the caribou is the animal on the back of our Canadian quarter.
Okay.
And this species has disappeared from about 50% of its historic range in Ontario.
Oh my goodness.
It just gets pushed further and further north as industry expands.
That's a really scary thought, considering just how prominent within Canadian culture they are.
Yeah, and I mean, the decline continues, that's the thing. And in the London area specifically, I mean, London is situated in Carolinian Canada, and that's a part of the country that is one of the most biologically diverse anywhere, and it's also one of the most threatened places in the country. So many examples of endangered species from there, but I'll begin with turtles. So 7 out of 8 of the turtle species in Ontario are at risk. And one of those is a spiny softshell that you find in the river that runs through London. But another one would be the common snapping turtle. Its name is common snapping turtle, but it's now on the species at risk list. And despite that, it's even legally hunted in the province.
Really?
Yes.
I see, turtles never for one moment came to my mind, let alone that many of the turtles.
Yeah. So, I mean, the primary problem is the primary problem for almost all species at risk in the country and around the world is habitat loss and habitat degradation.
Yep.
So one thing that's really hard on most turtle species is the loss of wetlands in Ontario. We've lost over 70% of our historic wetlands in southern Ontario, for example. But also the road network, because so many turtles, you know, they move from the place where they hibernate to the place where they lay eggs and so on, and they get killed on roads all over the place. And then also some of our turtle species are really cute, like the spotted turtle and the wood turtle, and they get poached for the pet trade.
Yeah.
So they're facing a number of very serious problems. Other species in the London area, there's lots of birds that are in big trouble, but one that bothers me personally quite a bit is the barn swallow. Now, barn swallow is one of those common species that's familiar to anybody who's been looking at birds. But they're now in very steep decline, and they've been listed as a threatened species in Ontario. And I'm sure that you've been hearing news about pollinators and bees in the decline that they're facing in Ontario and across North America?
Yes.
Yes, well, I mean, a lot of the attention is around honeybees, but in fact, we're seeing the same kinds of declines with our wild bees. There's a bee that was added to the species at risk list just recently called the rusty-patched bumblebee, and this is one of our wild bumblebees, one of our wild pollinators. It was once common and widespread across southern Ontario. It's now listed as endangered, and there have only been a handful of specimens collected in recent years in Ontario. They may, in fact, be gone from the province.
That's a really scary thought.
Yeah, and then take another example would be monarch butterfly.
Yes, I
now,
do know that one.
I mean, they hit the news. It's a pollinator species. It was very common when I was growing up, but mm-hmm. it suffered very serious population declines in recent years.
Yeah, I've noticed the difference between even my childhood and nowadays, just the amount of loss in monarchs. I rarely see them these days.
Yeah, it's very, very sad and very serious.
Now, while we're talking about the endangered species Ontario, a lot of people don't realize that plants also take part in this whole situation. Name some of the endangered species of plants in Ontario.
Sure. There are dozens and dozens of endangered plants in Ontario. And those range from trees to ferns to grasses to wildflowers right across the board. An example that you may never have seen in your life is the American chestnut. I've seen a few very scrawny American chestnuts I even have one in my backyard, like it's about an inch wide in diameter. But anyway, this was once the dominant tree species in our southern Ontario forest, and it's virtually gone. It was wiped out by an introduced blight that it couldn't resist, so it's now endangered. Another example would be wild ginseng, and this is a plant that you may never have seen either, but it is a plant that's very appreciated for its medicinal qualities.
Yeah.
And so it's been impacted not only by habitat loss, but also by collectors who poach it to sell it and make money, because there's a market for these, you know, medicinal plants.
Yeah. Well, another one, I was doing some research, the Ontario Trillium. There's actually four different kinds of trilliums that are on the endangered list.
Well, I think there's only one that's on the endangered list.
Oh, okay.
As far as I know. But I would need to check that, actually, to be sure. But the white trillium that we normally see, that's not on the endangered list.
No. But it is scary that another predominant part of Canada is on the decline there.
Well, it is, because especially when you see these common species like the ones I've mentioned, barn swallow, monarch, American chestnut used to be, these were once common species that are in serious decline.
Now, are there any species that are rebounding from being endangered or at least beginning to increase again?
Yeah, there have been a few. I think the two most notable examples would be bald eagle and peregrine falcon.
Okay.
Both of these birds were in very serious decline a few decades ago, and that was because of the use of a pesticide called DDT in agriculture. And anyway, eventually that pesticide was banned. It was banned in the 70s, and since then they've made a strong comeback, and they can often be seen across southern Ontario. Well, I shouldn't say often. They can be seen if you are looking in southern Ontario. And for me, you know, it's an example of what we can do if the government is willing to pass and enforce a strong law to address the cause of decline. Laws can't address everything, but in some cases they can definitely address these causes of decline.
It goes to show what we are able to do to help out these animals.
If we're willing.
Yeah.
But then, you know, when you think that habitat loss and degradation is the primary cause of species decline, you realize that there's some very powerful interests who would be opposed to seeing restrictions on, you know, land development, etc.